Getting started around 11:45 in the afternoon out of the Onoville Marina, which is located about midway down through the Kinzua Reservoir. Kinzua Reservoir is made from the Allegheny River with a dam, which is located down in Pennsylvania. Just around that corner there, just off my right paddle when I raise it there, is where I'm headed. I'm headed around the bend there. I'm gonna go across over the state line and on into Pennsylvania. I've made it around that corner. Directly to the right of me, where I'm looking now, is actually State Line Bay, which is a favorite old haunt of mine with powerboats. Directly off where I'm pointing is where I'm headed. At this point, I'm 1 hour in. I've got about another half an hour to go. And it's right straight ahead of me there, right where the bow of the boat is headed. It's a nice day to paddle. There was some traffic on the lake, but not a whole ton of it. It made for a nice paddle. It was just out in the middle of the channel there, which made it a little tough, but it wasn't bad. Finally landed about an hour and a half in. To the paddle, and found a nice spot here, a place called Hook's Brook, which is a small little creek brook that goes down out of the mountain there and into this little bay. But the campsite was nice. I was a little worried because it's first come, first serve, and I had heard it was pretty popular, but ended up being the only one there, and I got my pick of the nicest lot there and got things started to set up. Felt pretty ingenious here. I hung a rope from the tree there and decided to be lazy and not have to bend over, and put some hooks on the line and hung most everything that I needed up there, you know, that I didn't actually need, but made it accessible if I did need it. Next up, it was time to set up my hammock. Found a nice spot up in the woods a little bit. It wasn't very far, it's just the angle of the camera here that makes it look farther, but finally got that set up and gave it a try here. Everything worked out okay. The hammock's kind of cool. It's got a mosquito net built right into it that zips up and makes it mosquito-proof. And once the camp was set up, it was time for a nice cold beer. Cheers. Got my fire started.
Here come the fire.
Getting ready to have some lunch here.
Nice camp spot. We're in a little cove here called Hook's Brook. And the whole lake is out there. Great little spot. Love it.
This goes way up in a couple other camp spots up there.
There's the hot dog on the fire. Once again, this is Hook's Brook Bay. It's pretty deep in there. I was surprised. There were some boats in there when I first got there that were fishing, so they hadn't caught much. But up there was where the brook comes in. I had some time to sit back and relax and have a cigar. A little after lunch treat. Went on a wood hunt and found a neat stump that was left over. And see my smoke from my campfire coming out of the camp and found some interesting berries there.
Take a little hike up here. See what's going on. Beautiful woods up here. A little nervous about bear. It's the only thing I'm really nervous about. Everything else seems really cool. A little brook over here is beautiful. Look at that thing. That's beautiful. Take a little walk through here. See what's going on. Built a little shrine here. Kind of cool.
Got the fire nice and stoked for dinner as the sun started to go down here a little bit. We will have a really nice meal of steak and mushrooms. And then afterwards, I had a nice s'more. I roast the marshmallows. Turned out excellent. One of the best s'mores I ever had. There was a shot in the morning of all the fog that was up. Finally started to lift around 8:30, 9 o'clock. Had some nice breakfast, bacon on the fire there, and I had some eggs. It was time to shove off. I guess it was about 10:30 or so. Started my paddle back. I have to go straight ahead of me and around that corner again. The whole trip was about 5 miles or so. See, the water has a little green tinge to it. There was an algae bloom happening while I was down there, and you could see a little bit of algae floating in the water, little tiny particles, which is normal for this time of year. Lake Erie goes through the same type of process. All in all, great.